with that down, let's move on to our fourth main topic today, which I'm going to tell you I'm pretty excited about. Our fourth main topic today, guys, comes to us from Anders Villashrev, who writes, I thought I must have been reading something wrong, but apparently Harley Quinn Season 2, which, by the way, I just watched the Season 1 finale a few days ago, Harley Quinn Season 2 is going to launch in April, like this April, 4 months after the debut of Season 1. Don't get me wrong, I'm completely excited, but what is the strategy here? Why release the second season so soon? Thank you, and bring on the filthy. All right, thanks a lot for sending that in, man. And listen, if for those of you who haven't been around, you're not regular viewers here, the Harley Quinn animated series is a series that I had no interest in watching. I thought it looked bad. I'm not generally a big fan of either Marvel or DC's animated stuff. There are some exceptions. There are some big exceptions. But for the most part, I usually don't like their animated stuff very much. And I just started getting bombarded with people telling me, John, you really need to check out this Harley Quinn show. So I finally gave in and watched episode one and sat down and watched it with me. And I've been absolutely hooked on this show ever since. This is one of the most purely entertaining shows on TV. I'm not going to say it's Shakespearean. I'm not going to say it's Emmy winning, but on a level of pure entertainment, there are very, very few shows on television right now that just purely entertain me as much as this Harley Quinn show does. And I got to, and my favorite character is Poison Ivy in it. The Poison Ivy character who is voiced, Lake Bell, who's voiced by Lake Bell. I'm a big fan of Lake Bell. I love her. Anyway, I just watched the season finale and I thought, man, it kind of sucks that I got to wait a year to see this again. Rob, they are going to launch season two on April 3rd. On April 3rd. Like 2 months from now, less than 2 months from now, they're going to launch the next season. Other than some reality kind of shows, Rob, shows like, The Voice or some of the cooking shows, you know, they'll do a season and then their season will be over and then they'll like ramp up the next season almost right away. But very, very rarely in narrative shows do I see anything like this. So, Rob, let me ask you. Can you think of another example of a narrative show that has its season, ends its season, and then launches its next season less than 2 months later? And what do you think the strategy of DC here is by doing this?
Well, I think, look, you know, they weren't anticipating that the Harley Quinn movie, I think, underperformed the way it has. Mm. And I think what they were doing is they had their show dropping around the same time, a little bit before, ramping up excitement for the Harley Quinn character, which, by the way, I don't necessarily think has gone away, because their Harley Quinn show is the series, the animated series, has been very well received by the fans and people really like it. So I think that was always the plan. Then they release the movie and they roll into the next season because they were hoping for a lot of enthusiasm coming off the film and really solidifying that character, because they've got, remember, James Gunn's Suicide Squad coming out as well. So yeah. I think that, you know, in a way, ultimately, look, Suicide Squad, I mean, Harley Quinn, Birds of Prey underperformed. That doesn't mean people don't like the Harley Quinn character. And I think in a way, this strategy keeps that character alive, keeps the character fresh. And as they move into Suicide Squad, it's all ramping up to that anyway. Much bigger budget, a lot more stakes involved. So I think it's a smart move. I like the fact that they had it ready to go, you know, that they probably produced it all at once and just split up the season, the kind of the way they do with The Walking Dead. So good on them. I think that was a great strategy.
You know, one of the things that I wonder, because there have been times with movies that we have seen a film franchise, I think one of the victims of this was Wreck-It Ralph. I thought they simply waited too long to put Wreck-It Ralph 2 out. Now, it still did okay, and it was still a very entertaining little movie, but I always thought you needed to get another one out like less than 4 or 5 years after the first one. And part of me wonders if part of the strategy here, and I don't know that this is the case, I'm just wondering, if part of the strategy here is them going, we need to keep our momentum going. You know, we think we've got something here that the fans of liking. Remember, they just recently announced this second season. They didn't let us know the second season was coming this soon. Part of me wonders if they just realized, look, people are enjoying this show. We've got some momentum. We're getting some good word of mouth out there. We need to keep the ball rolling. Let's just move up that second season release from December or whenever they theoretically might have been releasing it. Let's just put it out there right now. So the optimist side of me, Rob, is thinking, this is them thinking, we got to strike while the iron's hot, keep the momentum going, let's keep the party going. The pessimistic side of me is wondering if this might not be in some way, shape, or form a harbinger of doom for the DC streaming service with the upcoming HBO Max. Because, you know, I've theorized before, Rob, that I think ultimately, I think they're going to kill off the DC streaming service and just kind of absorb it into HBO Max. I don't know that, been no official word on that. I'm just speculating. That's just pure speculation on my part. But a part of me wonders if part of this is, you know what? We don't even know if DC streaming service is going to be around long enough for us to get this out properly. Let's just put it out there now. I mean, I don't know. I hope it's the first thing. I hope it's them just wanting to keep the momentum going. Do you think there's any possibility? Am I being overly paranoid? Do you think there's any possibility this could be about their fear of the future of the platform itself? Or do you think it's probably something completely outside of that?
No, I don't think it's about fear. You know, I think it's outside. I think, like you said, I think it's outside of that. You know, we're moving into a new era, and I, like we keep saying on the show, it's like the Wild West. What's going to happen? How is everything going to be positioned? And what does the future hold for everyone? And I think it really is people are charting new courses as they move forward, and it's going to be interesting to see what happens. And I don't think anybody quite knows what's going to happen yet.
All right.
What do you think?
I mean, I'm not really sure yet. It's on the one hand, my first primal reaction is, oh joy, I got more Harley Quinn coming in just like literally weeks. It's literally weeks away, you know?
But, I mean, you're the guy. You weren't going to watch this show until word of mouth, real word of mouth hit you. And then you tuned in and you've been doing nothing but singing the show's praises. So it exists in its own continuum and has its own new audience, you being one of them. And it proves that even if a movie underperforms, you can have a series that's a breakout hit.
Yeah, I mean, because, again, television movies, I mean, Harley Quinn is a great example, Rob, like you're pointing out. Television and movies, there are two different sets of criteria for what, just because something is a successful TV show does not mean it's going to be a successful movie and vice versa. I got to tell you this, too, because I keep forgetting to mention this whenever I talk about Harley Quinn. Alan Tudyk might be my favorite animated Joker now.
Ooh. Really?
I know
those are fighting words, son.
That's sacrilegious to say in a world where we have the great Mark Hamill and his incredible Joker. I don't know. Maybe it's just equal. I don't know. But Alan Tudyk does a magnificent job of Joker. And the chemistry between Joker and Harley in it is fabulous. And the chemistry between Joker and the other members of the Legion of Doom is so funny. Bane is one of the... Oh, so much good stuff.
Just listening to how you talk about this show... I mean, you can't talk about it without getting a big smile on your face.
It's true. I get happy when I think about it.
I mean, that just shows what they're doing and how right it is. And isn't that what we want from our entertainment? It's great.
Yeah. Yeah. So anyway, guys, this is a very unusual situation. Like, again, I can't think of another situation that's exactly like this one from a narrative point of view where they're launching season two so quickly. But what do you guys think about it? Maybe you don't even watch Harley Quinn yet and it's not your bag, and that's totally cool. Are you excited about this or are you not? Jump down to the comment section below and let us know your thoughts. All right.